Hello crochet lovers, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be making a maroon purple skirt. This is a skirt that I made a while ago. Look at how good it looks, the elastic waistband. This is what we're going to create. First off, we take yarn and a hook. I'm using the purple Winter King yarn. And this is a 4mm hook, slip knot. We're going to chain 10 chains. So this is the foundation chain. For the first row of this waistband, we're going to use the slip stitch pattern on every chain all the way through the 10 chains. Chain one, turn and start and continue on the third row. One thing I learned about crocheting is it's just a repetition of the basics that you know. Once you know how to slip stitch, how to create a slip stitch, it will be easier for you. There are many tutorials on the slip stitch, which I will add the links to my description. We're almost done making the elastic waistband. You see now how good it looks. It stretches very, very well. We're finally done crocheting the waistband. Yeah, it stitches very easily. And after I got to know this stitch, I've been using it ever since. Because for a skirt, it gives you a very good elastic feeling. It's almost the same size as the one I had made, but I added 1 inch. So it's 29 inches waist. So now we join from the start to the finish, and then we get ready to start the first row. I also join using the slip stitch because it just creates the same pattern, and I didn't want it to look very different. Like, everyone can notice that it's where I started and where I ended it. Now we're finally done making the elastic waistband, and it looks very, very good. It stretches very well, and it's 29 inches. So I chain one, and look through the holes. When it comes to this waistband, it's very tricky because you have to really find place where you'll place your single crochet and double crochet. So it's basically alternating between a single crochet and double crochet stitch. now starting the second row, which is purple crocheting. I use this stitch markers to determine the middle part of the, like not the middle, the both ends where I'll be increasing. So, you know, even if the waistband is 28, 29 inches, our hips are wide. So let's say 45 inches. So you have to increase on both sides, on both ends, where the stitch markers are. When it comes to increasing using this pattern, it's a very, very tricky part. So I'll create a different tutorial to show you step by step how I increase on both sides. I increase until the fifth or seventh row, and then I just start crocheting all through the stitches without increasing. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So now I'll just be basically crocheting all through, just using the same way I did in the beginning without increasing. Until I always crochet like 40 rows for mini skirt. That's 20 purple rows and 20 maroon rows. And in this skirt, I decided to add another elastic waistband at the bottom of the skirt to make it look longer. So here it is, this is the final result. I did every single thing that I had said I'll do in the beginning. So this is how the skirt looks. I just can't wait to wear it.